Hugh Richards.
Oh,
from
yes,
Cardiff.
Mr. Hugh Richards, yeah.
Hugh said that if we win 1-0 tonight, I'm going to run naked around the block, waving my MK Dons scarf above my head. Now, unfortunately for Hugh, it was 1-0.
We did win 1-0 last night, yeah.
So a lot of people were taking Hugh up on this, asking where, you know, when the pictures are going to be put up.
When you say a lot of people, you were leading this.
He was, definitely.
I was looking from afar. I didn't want to be found out. Anyway, I've been in contact with Hugh. Apparently, there will be a video posted on the MK Dons Facebook page on Saturday prior to Peterborough. And we're going to have Hugh on the show in a few weeks' time as well.
Excellent one. Yeah,
looking forward to it. Just to find out his rationale from throwing something as stupid as that out there.
Excellent one. Oh, that's cool. Yeah, looking forward to that. All right, anything else to add about last night?
Glad to see George Williams back.
Yeah, George Williams.
Although he left in a bit of a bad way.
It does seem like people have forgotten about that now.
Seems to be swept under the carpet a little bit, isn't it?
For me, I saw him on TV a few months ago when Fulham were playing, and he looked really good. And he's a Wales international. He's young, and he was good when he was 16, so he should be even better now.
Yeah, you're right.
Good signing, I think. Good signing.
I find it difficult to accept the fact that anyone that plays for Wales can be considered international, because it's not a country, is it?
Says a man who follows Scottish football, for goodness sake.
Wales
can I just
is
ask
not
regarding
a country.
George? Is he still the youngest goal scorer?
He still is, yeah.
It's not a country.
16 years old, 16 and 247 days.
247.
Darren Boy, it's not a country, it's a principality.
To be fair, I did get a call up to the Wales squad, but I did turn it down for MKDSA FC related
things. Because
it's
not a country. Anyway, just saying, Wales, you're not a country, a principality.
So Wales, please let us know what you think on this one. We expect to hear from you soon. I've had tweets. Is that from Wales? Hang on a minute.
Could you imagine?
No, that's retweets. Oh, okay. Ollie Welch listening for the first time tonight.
Ollie Welch, he's not a person.
It says Ollie Welch. I hadn't even noticed that. Ollie Welch says, listening for the first time tonight and loving the MooCamp Radio Show. Hashtag where do I sign up? You just have. That's it. Done. You're now one
We've
of us.
We've got you.
You'll know Ollie when you see him, though. He's the big lad who sits with glasses. He's only like 18, but he looks a lot older. No offence, Ollie, and I love you, you know that.
Isn't that Thingy from the forum?
I don't go on the forum.
Okay.
Since I got called a chav by a drummer, I refuse to.
That might be a different Ollie.
You never know.
Okay, all right. Okay.
Awkward, so.
Yes.
What else is going on?
All right, let me get rid of that for a minute. Let me do this. You are listening to the MooCamp Radio Show on Seclo Sounds. And Seclo Sounds exists to bring people and communities together to celebrate all that's best about the city, or town, or principality, or Wales, or whatever it is. We produce a variety of music and speech programmes produced by local people, and we're run by over 60 volunteers. There's always room for more, so if you have a programme idea or a skill that you want to offer, send an email to volunteers@seclosounds.org, as Twilley has. And you can find out more about this show, the station, and other shows that we produce by visiting www.seclosounds.org. Now, bearing in mind, Gers is actually not paying attention and knows it's his bit again.
Where's it, Mabba?
It's the bit you always forget.
What's left?
It's the bit that's not been written.
We actually spent it again.
What's left? Nothing. Okay. There'll be bits left. There'll be things happening. There'll be Carolyn and Lisa updates.
That's very
Maybe
true.
Maybe some texts and tweets, and if we go really, really quickly, there'll be some Bootsy.
Okay, give us an update in terms of where we are, in terms of the poll that everyone needs to know about.
It is very, very close at the moment, very close indeed. So your votes do count this week. I can tell you it's looking like it's going to be an equalising goal.
Ooh. Interesting. Okay, I'm guessing there are texts and things. What do we got?
There are texts and tweets. Paul from Tinker's Bridge says, I'd like to make it perfectly clear that despite suggestions to the contrary made earlier in the show, I do not have any interest in seeing Young Alby naked. I'd much rather see modders in the nodders.
It's Hugh that said he'd streak, not me.
Yeah, we're all looking forward to that. Stephen the Lakes, he says, a bit of an upset recently, but that changes nothing. We're still going up as champions. Could you say the champions word? And Mr. Sozy from Shenley says, that guy gets it. I have no clue what that means, but congratulations. Simon from London says, looking forward to the Posh game, though mum's the word, of course. Ooh. And Pauline from Linslade said, my head hurts.
Excellent.
Sorry,
thank
Pauline.
You, Pauline. It's not the first time I know. Oh, that's not the right button. Oh, it's hidden. This just in, following the brilliant decision to once again field Ian, I tweet, I do, McLaughlin in goal in the recent game against Colchester United, ahead of David England's number one, Martin, Carl Robbo Robinson spoke out in response to some of the recent bad press that Ian had received. He said, No matter how hard you try, no matter how many trying schedules you fit in, there's always going to be something that proves to be greater than anything you can either try or do. That being the case, I took his phone off him last Monday, and you can see how much better he's got since then, can't you? He entered our interview with the words, "God help you all." More on this when we've gauged the amount of angst that pours out of Ian's fingers.
As you should know by now, the Dons are undoubtedly the most popular club in the country. And Pete Winky Winkleman is not only the most popular chairman in the lower leagues, he's possibly the most popular man in football altogether. But just how widespread is Winky's fame? Who really loves him? Now, we've carried out some more research this week, and we can now say that Judge Rinder, Chris Pinder, Harold Pinter, Michael Petey Pointer, the Pointer Sisters, Sister Sledge, Percy Harmon, Hank Marvin, Marvin Gaye, Gay Byrne, Charlie Burns, Charlie Austin, Austin Powers, Stephanie Beeching, Baron Beeching, and all the cast members from every film Sacha Baron Cohen has ever made. All love Winky. As always, unfortunately, there were some people we failed to get an answer from. And even though we asked very nicely and even took cake with us this week too, it was no different at all. Aptly named Banton's chairman, Mark Lawn, was too busy directing, and it really is, was too Lawn, busy directing so questions regarding the upcoming television windfall his club will be receiving, away from the subject of re-turfing the pitch to answer, and the chairman of a now-believed defunct association from London was too preoccupied texting this very show with his answer to the question of the week to bother with such trivial questions, as he believes we should already know his feelings on this subject already, before finally adding, "See you Saturday."
We're sitting staring at each other. This one's
we are.
We at least know what happens with this bit.
Okay, we know how difficult it is. We do, but I can't read it. So we know how difficult it is to plan ahead with accurate forecasting. So here at the MooCamp Radio Show, we're proud to support the Bovril Forecast. It's brought to you by the lovely people at Forecast. Telling the future, one cup at a time. The forecast this week is served up as a cup final special, but only in the boycott end. Rule 14, 2.
Roses are red, 'tis lovely just smelling them, but your season is buggered when losing to Gillingham.
Okay, and old Bootsy's rules to being a proper fan is available from No Good Bookstores, priced £9.97.
It's a great man's birthday this week.
Which great man? Bootsy's.
Bootsy.
Happy birthday, Bootsy.
Happy 50, birthday, mate.
50 years.
Looking good.
Okay.
Darren's making doing the like semaphore in the
There's something very strange going on here. Yeah.
What are you doing?
Okay, look, we are rapidly approaching the end of the world as we know it. And that'll be the end of the show as well. So we just needed to go quick round of the houses. What do we got? In terms of the roundabout, what was it?
The roundabout was Calverton Lane roundabout, of course.
Oh. Calverton Lane,
yes.
Okay.
Yeah,
I've thought that.
That's on Watling Street, isn't it?
It is, yeah.
Yeah, yeah. Okay.
Knowledge.
Interesting. Yeah, you see.
You're
research.
A proper MK Dons fan, you.
I know I can say anything, you'll say yes to it. okay, right, and I guess the sisters, Carolyn and Lisa, result.
Lisa.
Even with that late vote there, it was Carolyn.
Carolyn, okay.
Lisa, I'm sorry.
One all. That's good. Yeah, you've let her down terribly on this one. Okay, look, you've been listening to the MooCamp Radio Show, which is probably better than watching tonight's EastEnders and then missing the best half altogether. Tonight's show was recorded live without the aid of a safety net and without a 7-second delay in transmission needed. The show was written by Brando and Modders with additional material from Gers, from Filthy Don and everyone in Walford with a guilty conscience. Before we actually get onto the last track and things, just need to say very quickly, we got Posh at the weekend. Isn't it weird that it doesn't actually seem to matter?
Yeah, I know, yeah.
What's our predictions? Very quickly.
I think they're going to win.
2-0. Yep. We've already beaten them.
3-2, there'll be loads of goals.
Okay, sounding exciting. All right, look, this is the Star Council, so have a great week. Bye.
On the day I had MK Pulse proudly sponsors Seclo Sounds. MK Pulse is Milton Keynes' local magazine, bringing helpful information on food, health, fashion, money, travel, culture and much more to 84,000 people every month. Plus news, views and what's on from around the city. If it's happening in Milton Keynes, it's in MK Pulse and it's available on